Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes nummer 1143 met een uitzending voor vandaag, 25 november 2017. Dit is het bulletin van zaterdag. This bulletin will be in English, but only a small part in Dutch. Deze uitzending is grotendeels in het Engels, maar eerst een stukje Nederlands. Deze uitzending is vandaag iets langer dan normaal. Ik wil aan het begin van de uitzending nog even wat reclame maken voor het Daily Minutes chatkanaal op internet. Dat chatkanaal is ongeveer een jaar geleden opgezet voor experimenten die ik later eens wilde doen met chatten via de amateurband. Inmiddels ben ik bijna zover dat dingen die als data op 2 meter worden uitgezonden ook in het chatkanaal te lezen zijn. Daarna zal het ook mogelijk zijn voor mensen die met een registratie als amateur om vanuit het chatkanaal dingen op 2 meter of op 70 centimeter uit te zenden. Het is geregeld erg gezellig op het chatkanaal, dat staat helemaal los van deze experimenten, maar het is wel waar. Je kunt Daily Minutes chatkanaal op verschillende manieren bereiken. Dat kan zowel vanuit de browser als met een speciale IRC-app. En dat gaat op de PC en ook op de smartphone met die app. Daarnaast is de chat 1-op-1 gekoppeld aan het Mattermost chatplatform van hobbyscoop.nl, dat ook via Hamnet te bereiken is. Tussen beide manieren van toegang is er geen groot verschil. Met name luisteramateurs zijn op het chatkanaal ook bijzonder welkom. Als je dus een keer na de Daily Minutes wilt meepraten en je hebt geen amateurcall of nog geen amateurcall, dan is dit de manier. Informatie over hoe je met de chat kunt meedoen kun je vinden op www.pa0ete.nl.
CQ, 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 calling all radio amateurs and shortwave listeners. This is GB2RS, the news broadcasting service of the Radio Society of Great Britain. It comes to you from G4NJH in Nottingham. The script of this broadcast is available on the RSGB's own website and at gb2rs.podbean.com. Now, for the radio propagation report compiled by G0KYAG3YLA and G4BAO, the solar flux index remained in the 70s last week, reflecting the continued absence of sunspots. Geomagnetic conditions were unsettled at the beginning of the week, but improved as the effects of a coronal hull passed. We were left with a mixed bag of HF propagation, with fair conditions at times and poorer ones at others. Highlights were the J5TD expedition to Guinea-Bissau and the Polish TO2SPD expedition to Saint-Barthélemy, with many radio amateurs filling much-wanted band slots. Other DX stations are on the air to form around the world as they prepared for this weekend's CQ Worldwide CW contest. Speaking of which, conditions seem likely to be fairly settled on Saturday the 25th, but another Earth-facing coronal hole looks as though it could threaten the ionosphere on Sunday the 26th. Saturday might be the best day for working DX in CQ worldwide, whereas Sunday may be a bit more unpredictable. If our prediction is correct and solar matter impacts the Earth, there is a possibility of an initial HF enhancement, but then declining at maximum usable frequencies as the K index rises. Otherwise, expect 20 and 15 metres to be the main bands for DX, with good 10 metre openings being very thin on the ground. Recently, some days have also seen some sporadic E responses in the ionosonde data, which can make a difference for local near-vertical incident sky wave activity on 80 metres in the evening, when the FO-F2 ionization is usually insufficient for inter-G nets. Since this may be related to jet stream activity, and there will be plenty of that this week, it is certainly worth a check. You can monitor the ionosphere using daily graphs available on www.propquest.co.uk. Now for VHF and up, the charts in both the primary longer range models seem to be locked into a low pressure story for next week, which can mean quite windy and often colder weather too. There's little cheer for the VHF-UHF bands in this pattern, except perhaps for the odd bit of rain scatter and showers run down the coasts on northerly winds. Both models do suggest a build-up of higher pressure to the west of Ireland later next week, and this may give some prospects for Tropo as we move into the following week, but otherwise it's looking very thin pickings for weather-related propagation this time. However, we're now into the build-up for what is often one of the better meteor showers of the year. The Geminids has a broad peak culminating on the 13th and 14th of December, but there are normally many meteors throughout the shower period giving useful reflections. Unlike many meteor showers, the Geminids is associated with the asteroid 3200 Phaethon rather than a comet. Minor shower Pupid Velids also start around the end of this weekly report, with a peak around the 9th of December. Moonlight may affect shower visual sightings, but this will not affect radio reflections. Talking of moonlight, the moon is waxing gibbous this week, with a half moon this evening, Sunday. The full moon is next Sunday. As we move into the latter half of the week, the moon path degradation is very low and better suited to smaller EME station operations. For those early birds, the morning moon will favour paths to the west, while the early and later evening moon will be better for paths to the east of the UK. That's it from the propagation team this week. A new easy-to-use amateur radio satellite was launched last weekend and was switched on for general use on Thursday. AO91, also known as RadFXSat and Fox1B, is a CubeSat that carries an FM transponder. The uplink is on 435.25 MHz FM, plus or minus Doppler, with a mandatory 67Hz CTCSS tone for access. The downlink is on 145.960 MHz FM. The present position of the satellite can be seen www.nfigure2yo.com, and all amateurs are invited to listen out for the bird. The northernmost point of its orbit periodically passes roughly over Bedford, meaning that it will give good service over the whole of the British Isles, Europe and beyond. Full details about the satellite are on the AMSAT UK website, tinyurl.com/gb2rs-2611A for alpha. By coincidence, another AMSAT mission, FunCube 1, also known as AO73, celebrated its fourth birthday in space this week. It's travelled well over 500 million miles in orbit since launch and has been received tens of thousands of times. On the subject of birthdays, the International Telecommunications Union celebrated 90 years of ITU Radio Communications Study Groups on the 21st of November, a 90th anniversary celebration issue of the ITU News magazine can be downloaded from tinyurl.com/gb2rs-2611b for beta. Also, ITU HQ Station 4U1 ITU will be active in the CQ Worldwide DXCW contest, with QSLs via operator's instruction. The recent RSGB VDSL survey highlighted the growing problem with RF noise radiating from phone lines carrying VDSL2 broadband services. Backed by the RSGB Legacy Fund, members of the RSGB EMC committee are researching and developing RF digital signal processing techniques to identify and perhaps help mitigate VDSL RFI. The first stage, which is currently underway, is analysing files recorded by amateurs around the country and submitting via the VDSL survey. The team will then report progress as it happens. This weekend sandwiches between so-called Black Friday and Cyber Monday. These relatively new traditions see discounts of all kinds from sellers, including RSGB Bookshop. If you're an RSGB member and have kept the RSGB up to date with your email address, you will also have received an extra discount voucher. All RSGB members are encouraged to visit http://therSGB.org/members from time to time to make sure all their details are up to date.
I'm Ono of the Foundations of Amateur Radio podcast in Australia, and you're listening to the Daily Minutes by Papa Alpha Zero Echo Tango Echo. Foundations of Amateur Radio. You know when you walk down the street and you lift your foot, and all of a sudden you realise that you stepped in something and now it's stuck to your shoe? I had that feeling during the week. Last week I mentioned that I had purchased a TCXO, a temperature-controlled external oscillator. Lowell, November Echo 4 Echo Bravo, set me straight by pointing out that XO stood for crystal, and TCXO stood for temperature-compensated crystal oscillator, which then led me on a merry goose chase trying to learn about all that. I mention this because while the stickiness on my shoe kept me busy, it also highlighted that I'm still a babe in the woods on a steep learning curve to knowledge with some roadblocks, diversions and potholes along the way. That reminds me, if you ever feel the urge to pull me up on something I've said, you can email me via my callsign at gmail.com. So how does this temperature compensated crystal oscillator actually work? Without getting into the security behind the scenes, as I mentioned previously, a crystal oscillates and the frequency is dependent on temperature. Turns out this is a predictable curve. which makes it possible to account for changes in temperature. In addition to keeping the temperature stable, another way to keep the frequency of a crystal stable is to have an electrical circuit that changes depending on temperature, and have that create something like an opposing curve so you can add the two together and end up with a pretty stable frequency. Before you start asking how exactly, let me just remind you of the shoe with the stickiness on it. In essence, you have something like a resistor that changes resistance depending on temperature. It's a component called a thermistor, and that in turn affects a resonance circuit, also known as an electronic oscillator or LC circuit, which in turn affects the circuit that is driving the crystal. These days, most if not all of that is on a chip, and you get a neat little package that you can plug into your radio to give it frequency stability and hopefully accuracy. I did say I was going to talk about accuracy this week, but the doo-doo I stepped in put a swift halt to that. Besides, now I know that there is a thing called a thermistor, the second portmanteau I ever learned, together with gerrymander, so there's that. Ah, also Tanzania, Eurasia, and Oxbridge. Back to amateur radio. The oven-controlled crystal I mentioned last week, they exist in high-end measuring gear, not in the $26 TCXO I have installed in my radio. While I'm on the subject, you can also compensate for temperature with software, using either a purpose-built microprocessor or even the host processor that is using the crystal. But that gets into magic, self-referencing voodoo pretty quickly. And while I've been playing, Japan is finally being received here, and I heard a station 18,656 kilometers away during the week. Mind you, Alpha Alpha 3 Golf Zulu in Doylestown, Pennsylvania, on the Atlantic Ocean side of the United States, was putting out 100 watts, so there's that. I'll leave you with a thought that I hope to be able to answer next week. If your radio has a crystal that determines what frequency it's tuned to, how do you use that to determine the accuracy of the frequency? More self-references, just because I can. And besides, I'm a software developer and recursion is part of my makeup. I'll give you a hint. It's not all to do with megahertz. I'm Onno, Victor Kilo 6, Foxtrot Lima Alpha Bravo. Ik ben Onno van de podcast Foundations of Amateur Radio in Australië. En je luistert nu naar de Daily Minutes van Papa Alpha Zero Echo Tango Echo.
Denk trouwens nog even aan het Daily Minutes chatkanaal. Daily Minutes zijn dagelijks vanaf ongeveer 1900 uur te beluisteren via PI2NOS. De uitzending wordt een dag later om 10:30 ochtends herhaald. Alle mail is welkom op het adres x@xdv.me. Dat is ook te vinden rechts bovenaan de webpagina van de uitzendingen www.pa0ete.nl. Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo. De Daily Minutes toont iedere dag weer aan de hand van schokkende voorbeelden hoe een hobby mensenlevens kan veranderen.
Even if you had turned location services off, even if you had never run any apps, even if you didn't have the SIM card in from your carrier, Google was actually tracking your location and the data were going back to Google about this. There was no way for a consumer to opt out of this. They're not alone in this. You know, Facebook is the other big company that is doing this. The only thing you could have done is not purchase an Android device. That's the only way that you could have avoided this happening.
Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo.